This 1830s building might make you think I'm close to some industrial heartland, but actually it was pivotal in protecting a vast area of countryside. Find out what it did and where I am in just a few moments. On today's show, a retired teacher, with help from her sister, hopes to find a country home closer to family. Property hunting is a steep learning curve.
I sense a little bit of hesitation.
Well, this is one room, isn't it?
Okay. Yes. Just you're taking your time.
Yes. Yes.
But one house is clearly top of the class.
Wow. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
Today I'm in Somerset, and these are the Levels and Moors. It's one of the lowest and flattest areas in the county, just a few metres above sea level. Until the 1950s, the Western Zoyland pumping station here was a vital engine room, draining away excess water so the land could be used for farming. And despite the struggle to keep the area above water over the centuries, the wetlands here are of international importance because of the wildlife that flocks here. In the heart of the West Country, Somerset is England's seventh largest county. Its land border includes Devon, and the shoreline stretches along the Bristol Channel. It's a county full of contrasting landscapes, from its dramatic rocky coastline to the low-lying flat terrain of the Somerset Levels. Coastal resorts include Burnham-on-Sea, famous for its lighthouse on legs. Built in 1832, it still warns local shipping of the shifting sands, flashing its light every 7.5 seconds. Inland, the Mendip Hills are popular with hikers and backpackers. The area is also home to Cheddar Gorge, the birthplace of Britain's most popular cheese. Pretty Somerset villages include Dunster, one of the best preserved medieval settlements in England. It grew up around a Norman castle, later rebuilt as a country home for the Luttrell family. With the added draw of the Exmoor National Park featuring rolling landscapes and a native breed of pony, this is a great county for aspiring country dwellers. In Somerset, the average price of a detached property is around £313,000, which just nudges above the national figure. The good news is that central and southern parts offer better value for money if you don't need those transport links up to Bath and Bristol, which is why North Somerset has a premium price tag. That bodes well for today's buyer, as easy access to the countryside is high on her agenda. Today's property shopper is retired maths teacher Debbie, who's brought along her older sister Sandra to help in her house hunt. For the last 15 years, Debbie has lived in a four-bedroom detached property in the heart of the West Midlands metropolis.
I live in a suburb of Birmingham called Marston Green, which is probably about 8 miles from the centre of Birmingham. You wouldn't know you were in Birmingham. It's quite a leafy suburb, although it's becoming more and more built up as the years go on. The cars, busy, busy, busy. The airport is close by. And I just look forward to a little more peace and quiet.
But there are other reasons for moving now. Sadly, Debbie was widowed last year. One of her two daughters is moving to Somerset with her husband and son for work. Debbie feels now is the right time to leave the home she shared with her late husband and spend more time with her young grandson.
I want to move there predominantly because my daughter and family are moving down there. I'm from the southwest, and I would love to go closer to my roots again. I've always hankered after it, but it hasn't been possible throughout my married life. And now it is. The opportunity's arisen, and I'm really quite excited about my return to that part of the country.
It's a major move, but fortunately Sandra, who also lives in the West Country, will help Debbie choose the right house.
I've enlisted the help of my older sister Sandra, who was the voice of reason, whereas I'm the impetuous one and would buy the first thing that I really like.
I think she's come to a stage in her life where it's time for the next move on, and this is an ideal opportunity to do it. I'll be the brain and Debbie can be the heart.
Although she's retired, Debbie certainly won't be slowing down.
things that I do here, I'll be able to do down there as well. Do a lot of sport, a lot of running, a lot of fitness. I play netball, I play tennis. So hopefully I'll be able to continue all that when I go down, and possibly a lot more. I anticipate doing some walking as well, which might make things better.
After nearly 40 years of living in Birmingham, Debbie is under no illusions about the move, but the positives definitely outweigh the negatives.
I'll miss my friends dreadfully. I'll miss my youngest daughter, who will still be living here, but it is only 2.5 hours away, and we've reconciled that, and we're going to see each other a lot. But I'm looking towards a slower lifestyle, a more relaxed lifestyle, and the rural aspect of the lifestyle.
Ideally, Debbie would like to find a property within a 30-minute drive of the village of North Petherton, where her daughter is moving to. I'm meeting up with her and Sandra to pin down her wish list.
Debbie and Sandra, welcome to Somerset. What brings you to this area?
Well, my daughter and son-in-law are relocating with their job, and as I'm on my own now in a very large house, I'm going to move with them.
So this move is all about family?
It's definitely about family, yes.
And the added bonus is you'll be closer to your sister?
Sandra lives in Cornwall, so we now cut the distance by half.
How well do you know this area?
Do you know, I don't know Somerset very well. Having been brought up in Cornwall, we didn't tend to stop in Somerset. We drove straight through it. So I'm really excited to see what Somerset's got to offer me.
And Sandra, you'll be here helping out your sister.
I will. Keeping her feet firmly on the ground.
So is that your job?
It appears to be, yes.
You're the sensible one.
Oh, we hope so. There's going to be very little room for manoeuvre. She's got her mind set on what she wants.
So, Debbie, tell us about those must-haves.
I want a good-sized garden. I'd like a large kitchen come diner. I want something period. I do not want anything new or modern. I'm not into that sort of thing. Access to amenities, and very important access to social and sports clubs particularly.
Anything else about the house? Okay. How many bedrooms?
Right, I would like a minimum of two, because although it's just me, I've got two daughters, a grandson, friends, family who will be visiting. So I want it to be a bit of a family house as well.
And what will you not compromise on?
I won't compromise on a decent garden. I won't compromise on the large kitchen.
And remind us of your budget?
Absolute maximum is 385.
I understand that that's not going to be a compromise.
That's not a compromise, no.
And you're in a good position to move?
My present property's sold.
Perfect.
Yep.
And so you're ready to go?
I'm ready to roll, yes.
Well, shall we hit the road, ladies?
Let's go.
Follow me.
For a maximum budget of £385,000, Debbie is very clear about what she wants and what she doesn't. The house must be old with character. It must have a kitchen diner and a minimum of two bedrooms for when Debbie's youngest daughter comes to visit. The garden should be a good size, and she wants a location close to amenities, so ideally on the edge of a village. We've done our homework and lined up a fine selection of Somerset properties for teacher Debbie to mark up rather than down, hopefully. But I won't be revealing the price until the end of each tour. Our mystery house is a classic nostalgia trip, but is Debbie ready to go the distance?
You sound very sporty. Do you run every day?
Not every day. I make sure I do at least an hour of something 5 times a week.
Wow.
Yeah, I go to boot camps 3 or 4 times. And if I can't get to one of those, I'll run.
And how well do you know the area?
I don't know it that well at all. Obviously, I've been on the internet and looked around. I drove down the once and had a good old drive around the back roads just to have a look and see.
I think a lot of the area that you're looking in is quite flat, which is great for running, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
For our first property, we're heading to the small village of Staple Fitzpaine, 12 miles from Debbie's daughter in North Petherton. Situated in the Blackdown Hills area of outstanding natural beauty, this rural village has a population of under 200 and is centred on a quiet crossroads where you'll find the local pub, a fine parish church, and some curious sandstone boulders, which, according to legend, were thrown down by the devil and bleed if you prick them. The first property has a more reputable backstory and is located at the heart of this peaceful village.
And here we have the front of house number one.
Wow. Okay.
So this used to be a schoolhouse in the 19th century. This was the mistress's house. So plenty of character, plenty of history.
Right.
And it's attached to what used to be the school back there. They're both now residential property.
So it's an attached property.
It's an attached property. We can see the gardens already. We'll talk more about it later.
Beautiful.
But it's in a really lovely setting, isn't it?
It is.
It's lovely.
It is.
What about the look of the house?
Well, it's an old school mistress's house, and I'm an old school mistress, so... I'm very excited about going into the house and having a look in there.
I'll take you through what is the original front entrance.
OK.
The former schoolhouse, built from locally quarried blue limestone, gets a gold star from retired teacher Debbie for its visual appeal. And I'm hoping she'll also feel right at home inside, as it's full of character.
So the main entrance takes us straight into this lounge.
Yep. Then you've got the open fire.
Yeah.
And a beautiful open fireplace.
Oh,
and
yes.
And a lovely window seat. If you
lovely.
Oh, we like a window seat.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, what do you think about the style and the look of the lounge?
Style's OK. Yes, I like the open fire. It's nice and light. Yes.
I sense a little bit of hesitation.
Well, this is one room, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yes. Just you're taking your time?
Yes.
OK.
Yes.
Definitely.
I don't dislike it.
Not a bad start. Let's head on into the kitchen.
The lounge leads onto a dining room with more old-school features, including exposed stonework and an open fireplace with wood burner. The kitchen is located in a single-storey extension at the front of the property.
Very modern.
It is, isn't it?
It doesn't quite go with the rest of the house, but this is the extension, so you'll see the former external wall here.
Yes.
So you can tell this is the extension.
Yes.
And what you have is this kitchen, quite a sizable utility room and a downstairs shower room as well.
Yes. Is it big enough for you? I think so.
Mm-hmm.
I think so. Mm. Okay.
Debbie's being cagey about the kitchen, and I sense the modern finish isn't her style, but of course she could easily change that. Time to retrace our steps back through the dining room and living room and head upstairs. Of the three bedrooms in the property, one is a single currently used as a study. There's a guest double for when Debbie's daughter comes to stay. They're both serviced by a light, bright family bathroom. That just leaves the main bedroom.
This is what the current owners use as a master.
Okay.
You're saying the word okay a lot.
Okay. Yes. This is absolutely fine. This would be fine as a bedroom.
But you don't love the house, do you?
Do you know, there are features I'm beginning to see that I'm not liking. And the kitchen is a major one. It's far, far too modern for me.
Mm.
Although Debbie still has those reservations about the style of the kitchen, I have one last ace up my sleeve, and that's the outside. Debbie wanted a large garden, and the total plot is 2/3 of an acre. As well as the space at the front of the property, she also gets this patch at the rear, with a sizable lawn, vegetable plots, greenhouse, and various well-maintained flower beds.
So here's the final part of the garden jigsaw. It really does go all the way around the house.
Yes.
Really.
Yeah, I love it. I love the garden. That's definitely my best feature. I'm worried about that window next door.
Aha, so one of their windows overlooks...
Overlooks directly into my privacy.
Mm. And it's a downstairs
that
one.
Is a deal breaker.
Really?
Yes. I'd be aware of somebody looking out constantly.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. And that's a
and
shame.
And that's something that couldn't be changed, whereas other things could have been.
Yeah. So the gardens might not be enough to sway you.
No, they're beautiful.
Absolutely
stunning. I love them, but I don't love that.
Well, we still have to discuss price.
OK.
Who'd like to go first?
I think it's in the region of £380.
Ooh, I was slightly lower. It's about 365.
OK. It's actually currently at the very top of your budget. So the current owners want offers in excess of
£385,000. OK.
OK.
And in fact, it's been reduced in the last couple of months.
Oh,
it was on for nearer £400,000.
Right.
And it's been reduced.
Okay.
To within your budget.
Yeah.
Well, it's always worth having another look at a house once you know the price. So why don't you do that and I'll meet you out front in a bit.
Okay, thank you.
Right.
Priced at offers over £385,000, our first property is a former schoolhouse dating to the 19th century with character features and a side extension with modern kitchen. There's one more bedroom than Debbie asked for, and the house is set in two-thirds of an acre, but it seems the pretty garden and village location isn't enough to sway Debbie.
It's a lovely property. The gardens are stunning, they're beautiful. I would love those. But there are too many features that I would want to change. But being at the top end of my budget, I wouldn't have the finance to do that.
It's beautiful setting. The location is stunning. But for me personally, to live here, I couldn't do that. But to visit, most definitely.
Do you still feel it's not the property for you?
It's not the property for me.
The good news is we've still got another two to see. Onwards and upwards.
Lovely.
Fitness enthusiast Debbie can't wait to explore the countryside. Although she's set on making Somerset her home, she's only visited the area on one previous occasion. So we sent her and Sandra for a local history lesson with a bit of walking thrown in for good measure. They're starting off in North Petherton, and where better to begin their enlightening tour than at the parish church? Local historian Chris Sidway is the man in the know.
We've noticed this church, Chris. It's absolutely beautiful.
The name of the town, North Petherton, the Tun is Anglo-Saxon, but the Pether is Celtic, and it means the Tun, the Saxon settlement, on the north of the River Parret. It was also a major royal hunting forest, and so when the settlement was established, the church itself was what is called a minster church, or a mother church.
Like its larger cousin in York, the minster at North Petherton was a missionary church in Anglo-Saxon times and an important centre for worship. The church was later rebuilt in the 15th century.
It must have been quite a wealthy town, a wealthy area to build a church
was.
Like this.
As well as having the royal hunting forest, Somerset was one of the counties that was very rich for its wool. Different towns had their own wool named after them. So there were Bridgewaters, Tauntons, Chards, and most famous of all, Watchets, which were a pale blue. And they were mentioned by Geoffrey Chaucer in Canterbury Tales.
Chris is Somerset born and bred, and his passion for the local area has led him to establish heritage walking trails through the countryside. The tour's going well so far, and as they head into the Quantock Hills, Chris is literally on the warpath.
We're standing on the Alfred Road. We like to think it was King Alfred, and perhaps part of his system of heripaths, or warpaths, to link his various burghs. But there was also a Norman lord called Alfred de Bagne, so it could have been from either, but we like to think it's King Alfred.
Whichever Alfred first marched along here, the track was still in use in the 19th century as a coaching road. 3.5 miles further on brings them to Fine Court, the site of a former home belonging to 19th century scientist Andrew Cross, who was fascinated with electricity. It burnt down in 1894, nothing to do with his experiments, thankfully, but today the ruins provide a backdrop to a fabulous nature reserve. Debbie and Sandra are finishing their tour by meeting Mel Warman from the National Trust to find out more about the scientist known as the Thunder and Lightning Man.
Did he do any famous experiments at all?
The one he was most known for was the most notorious. It is one that he carried out with volcanic rock. He was passing an electric current through a rock in liquid. And when he did it, he was kind of looking through the microscope and these weird little bugs started appearing. He mentioned this to one of his friends in a naive fashion who worked in the press, got published in the paper. Absolute outrage that Andrew Cross was claiming to have created life.
Accused of playing God, it turned out that Cross's instruments were probably contaminated. but his former laboratory at Fine Court serves as a fitting memorial to an early pioneer of power who tends to be overlooked. For our second offering, we're heading to the hamlet of North Newton, just 3.5 miles from Debbie's daughter in North Petherton. Situated in the low-lying Somerset Levels, the closest large village is North Curry, a prosperous settlement in the Middle Ages. A flourishing cattle market was established in the 13th century, but the area was also a favourite hunting ground for infamous ruler King John. Many of the buildings date to the 18th century, when the success of the wool trade boosted the local economy, and the post office was one of the first in England, opening in 1860. House 2 is a 10-minute drive away, surrounded by farmland. It's a quiet setting, but the property is already prompting the right noises.
Ooh. I can hear lots of oohs and ahs. House number 2, ladies.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm liking.
Yes.
It's a Somerset longhouse, so traditional farmhouse that dates back, they think, to the 14th century.
This is the original farmhouse.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, wow. Taking my breath away a bit.
Yes, it's lovely.
And a beautiful front garden, I'm sure.
Yes, yes.
This is more positive already than house number 1.
Yes.
Definitely. Yeah. Gosh.
And you agree?
I 100%. Absolutely.
That's what I like to hear. Shall we get inside?
Oh, yes, please.
A great reaction from both Debbie and Sandra to this traditional Somerset longhouse, which has recently been refurbished. The property is vacant, and with no chain, Debbie could move in straight away.
This is one of two lounges or sitting rooms, whatever you'd prefer to call them.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes.
Oh, she's off on a wander.
She is. Sorry.
Making herself at home.
Definitely.
Do you think that Debbie would suit a place like this?
I think she would.
It gives you a feel for the property, certainly.
It does give me a feel, and I'm liking that feel. Yes.
Great. Let's go to the kitchen because I know how important that is to you.
As well as this sitting room, there's a further reception room opposite with another fantastic feature fireplace. Knowing that Debbie has fixed views on the style of her kitchen, I hope this one might get top marks from her.
So you have a brand new kitchen here.
Gosh, yes. It's big enough.
Now, the kitchen in house number 1 was too modern for you.
It was indeed. Mm.
Is this a little better?
It's much better. I love the range. Mm-hmm. We've got the beams. And it just feels more homely.
Yes. It isn't so clinical, is it?
No. It's cosy.
That's the extent of the ground floor accommodation on offer. However, attached to the side of the house is a barn providing an excellent garage space with a mezzanine level. The upstairs of the house has been divided into two separate sections, each with its own staircase. One set of stairs leads to a double bedroom with its own bathroom, a guest suite for Debbie's daughter, perhaps. The stairs we're climbing lead to a double bedroom, which could be Debbie's master, as well as two further rooms.
Originally, there were 3 bedrooms on this side of the staircase, so this could be another bedroom, but the current owner's used it as a dressing room. It's really quite nice. So that means you can keep that quite cupboard-free, can't you?
Yes.
And then if you follow me...
That's a good idea.
The third bedroom...
Bedroom?
..was turned into a stunning bathroom.
Oh, my gosh!
Wow.
So up those stairs is your own suite, master suite. You don't have to share it with anyone, including your dear sister.
So far, so good.
Yes. Well, you've seen a lot of the house now.
Yes.
What are you thinking?
I'm still liking it.
Are you loving it, though?
I am, actually.
Outside, the house sits in a secluded spot surrounded by farmland. To the side of the barn is a courtyard area with numerous outbuildings, including 2 carports. The manageable garden has been designed for entertaining, with a lovely area for enjoying the evening sun.
So here we are. Back out in the garden, where you have a lovely summer house.
Yes.
Glass of wine area, I call it.
Very much so.
But we need to talk about money, ladies.
Oh, wow. Yes.
You're nervous this time, aren't you?
Very nervous. And the problem is, you've dangled this property in front of me, and I'm thinking it's going to be very, very expensive. I think 390, 395. I'll go 395.
OK. Sandra?
I'll go higher. I think 400. It's got to be.
Well, it was on the market for 425 a couple of months ago. It's been reduced to 395. We have spoken to the owners about your budget, and they have said they are open to offers. So,
okay.
If you're willing for some discussions,
I think a chat might be in order.
I think it, you know, it could be yours.
Okay.
Do you want it to be yours?
Yes.
You'd love it to be, wouldn't you?
And are you happy with that, Miss Sensible?
Yes. Yes.
Now that you know that,
yes.
Have another look around what could be your house.
Thank you.
And I'll meet you in a bit.
Okay.
Thank you.
I do think it's ideal for her. So I hope that it all works out because it's a lovely, lovely property.
Over budget, but certainly open to offers, the second property is a traditional Somerset longhouse, which has been lovingly renovated to highlight its original features. It has three bedrooms, including a self-contained guest suite, an attached barn, and is surrounded by rolling farmland.
Second bedroom. Yep. I'm really liking this because when you come to stay, you've got your own self-contained area, haven't you?
Self-contained stairs. Self-contained bathroom.
Bedroom.
Oh, how lovely.
Lovely, yes.
Yes.
The character of the property lends itself to everything Debbie was hoping for. The layout of the whole thing is just amazing.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, my.
Wow.
Goodness. I thought I'd seen it all. I didn't need any more convincing. I like this place. I can't believe this all belongs to this one little house. Initial reaction was sheer joy. Loved it. Loved the aspect. Loved the location. Loved the garden. Once I went inside, still loved it. Very impressed with the property. I really have fallen in love with it.
How exciting that you found somewhere you love.
It's very exciting.
And overwhelming.
Overwhelming is the word.
And then we've still got the mystery house to go tomorrow.
I look forward to it.
Let's get a drink before that, though.
We're in sunny Somerset, helping retired teacher Debbie from the West Midlands find a country home closer to family. She's brought trusted sister Sandra along for support. Up next, will our mystery house get an A star?
Oh, right!
It's cute, isn't
How
it?
How interesting is that?
Yeah.
It's a surprise.
It is a surprise.
A big surprise.
Yes.
And I pick up the scent on what could be Somerset's most fragrant farm.
But did you know anything about lavender farming before you started?
No, we didn't.
Yesterday was a day of extremes, with both Debbie and Sandra not warming to the old schoolhouse at all, but Debbie feeling very much at home in the Somerset farmhouse.
We've got a job on our hands beating it, but I'm hoping the mystery house will take Debbie on a classic trip down memory lane.
What are you both wanting from today's mystery house?
We've had a little bet between ourselves as to what you're going to sort of the type of property is going to be shown to us.
I think it's going to be a barn conversion.
Okay.
And Sandra? Yeah, I think the same. Well, I don't. I've got to go against Debbie, haven't I? I've got to think of something completely different off the wall.
This isn't a very good bet if you both think it's a barn conversion.
No.
Because I might be the only winner.
Yes.
All right,
could
I think
be in this.
It's probably going to be a little cottage.
You think a little
cottage? Yes, a little cottage tucked away, even a thatched cottage.
The mystery property is close to the village of Roadwater on the edge of the Exmoor National Park, a 45-minute drive from Debbie's daughter. The closest town is the pretty settlement of Watchet on the North Somerset coast, with its historic harbour romanticised by poet Samuel Taylor Coleridge in the rhyme of The Ancient Mariner. Debbie spent her childhood on the coast, and I'm hoping Watchet's charm will persuade her that the journey to her daughter is worth it.
You asked us to be within 30 minutes...
I did.
..of your daughter...
Yes.
..in North Petherton.
That's right.
What I'm asking you to do is consider an additional 10 to 15 minutes.
Okay.
So you'd have a lovely harbour marina to visit.
Yeah.
and a beach to visit.
Very nice.
With your grandson. I know you grew up by the coast.
Indeed. We did.
So how would it feel to be near the coast again?
Something I hadn't really considered, but I'm open-minded. I love the coast.
Of course.
And I just didn't think it was a possibility.
The Mystery House is a 15-minute drive inland from Watchet, just outside the village of Roadwater in the Brendon Hills. Amenities include a shop, a post office and a pub. Debbie seems sold on the location, but will the house be enough to sway her seaward?
Have a look at your Mystery House.
Oh, wow, that's different again.
Gosh.
Thatch cottage.
Yes. Cottage. Guess who's won their bet?
Yes, Cassandra said it would be a cottage.
Not a converted barn.
Not a barn as you thought it might be. A pretty chocolate box.
It is.
It is. Cottage.
It's quite small from here. Be interested to see inside.
Might be a TARDIS.
Let's go inside.
The 300-year-old Mystery Stone Cottage is the smallest property I've shown Debbie and Sandra, but hopefully the inside won't disappoint.
Ah, all right, OK.
That's a surprise. Kitchen and a cottage. Yes. And?
A lovely range.
Range.
A range.
Is it big enough for you, though?
Yes.
Lots of room in here, isn't there? More than I expected.
And it feels very country kitchen.
It feels yes. country kitchen, yes.
I don't think you'd want to change it.
No, no.
And has it been renovated recently?
It has, 5 years ago.
Oh, OK. Right.
Which is why I think everything's in such good condition. Yeah.
It is in good condition. It looks very nice. I like it. Really nice. I like all of it. I like the floor, I like the surfaces.
Yep.
I like the way it's being done, yes.
Next to the kitchen is the sitting room with steps leading down to a cosy snug. The centrepiece is a wonderful dual-facing log burner.
Oh, right!
It's cute, isn't
it? How interesting is that?
It's like a little snug down there.
Exactly.
Yes.
It's what an interesting layout.
Very. It's making the most of the space.
Yes.
Isn't it? Absolutely.
Yes.
And always nice to have a log burner.
Oh,
love them. Love them.
Especially in a house like this.
Yes.
Oh, definitely.
Yes. Didn't expect this. Yeah.
It's a surprise.
It is a surprise.
A big surprise.
Yes.
Because although it is small,
yes,
it's not too pokey, is it? It's
no,
quite homely.
Exactly, and that just opens it out.
Mm. Yes,
to make it feel much bigger, doesn't it?
Let's head on upstairs.
Okay.
The only bathroom in the property is also found on the ground floor. Upstairs there are two bedrooms. One is a twin, which is where Debbie's family guests could stay. But we're heading to the master.
That's unexpected.
Right.
Everything about this cottage is unexpected.
It is.
Isn't it?
It is.
Is everything bigger than you thought it
yes,
would be?
This is, definitely.
Oh, in terms of from the outside?
Mm, yes. There's a lot of furniture in here.
I don't think you'd necessarily need this much.
No.
But I don't know your wardrobe size.
Oh, I've got lots.
So perhaps the second bedroom is your walk-in wardrobe.
Okay.
Slash Harry's room.
Yes. Have we not got another bedroom?
Nope, only two bedrooms.
Right, OK.
OK, and the other bedroom is very similar to this one.
Similar size, yeah.
Right. OK, I'm feeling it's very small for me.
In terms of the size of the rooms or just the overall space?
Overall space.
Debbie asked for a minimum of two bedrooms, but perhaps our previous properties with three bedrooms have raised her expectations. Outside, a much-loved garden wraps itself around the cottage and includes a vegetable plot with raised beds and space for entertaining.
The type of garden you'd like?
Yes. Yes, it's certainly the size I would like, and there's lots of scope to do all sorts with it, yes?
Yes. Yes, it's so peaceful.
And it's been beautifully done, hasn't it?
It's very well
stunning.
Done. Very
Absolutely.
Well done. There's a lot in that area. It just, I'm amazed it's so big.
Yeah.
How much would this property set you back, though?
Wow. Gosh. I'll go for $350.
I think around $330.
It's actually on the market for £375,000.
Okay.
And that's been reduced, actually.
Oh, gosh.
So you have to remember we're North Somerset, where prices are a little bit higher.
Okay.
We're inside the National Park.
Yes. I forgot that.
And there's a good area of land.
Yes,
too.
Yes. Exactly. Do you want to have another look around?
I think that's a good
idea.
Explore
more of the garden as well.
Yes, yes, we'd love to.
And I'll meet you out the front.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
under budget by £10,000, our characterful mystery thatched cottage comes with a large kitchen and two bedrooms. The garden is sizeable and well maintained, but the location, a few miles from the North Somerset coast and inside the Exmoor National Park, takes Debbie outside her family comfort zone.
Could you see yourself in this room?
Well, yes, actually. I wouldn't feel claustrophobic in here at all. Even though it's a small window, it's very light and airy in here. And look at the views. Stunning.
Yeah. It made me realise that actually there's a lot more up towards this coast than perhaps I've been looking at. So I wouldn't have precluded this property on the basis that it's a little bit further away.
It's beautiful property. It's been lovingly restored. It's in beautiful condition. Unfortunately, I think it might be too small for Debbie.
Time's up, ladies. You've seen your three houses.
We have.
And it's lunch.
Oh, lovely.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Like many rural areas in Britain, the Somerset farming economy faces challenges. With milk prices falling, many local dairy farmers have started to diversify in order to survive. One such farm is Horse Pond in the village of Falkland. Where cows once roamed the fields, today the fragrant scent of lavender fills the air. Farmer Francis Green, along with his wife Judith, have been growing lavender for the last 10 years. It's harvesting season, so I've chosen the perfect time to find out more about the qualities of this purple bloom.
This is absolutely stunning here.
Yeah, thank you.
What made you choose lavender?
Lots of other people diversify into making ice cream, holiday lets. We wanted to do something different. Both Judith and I are interested in gardening and love of plants, and we came across lavender, and here we are.
Well, I've just been watching you harvest. Yeah. Talk us through that process.
It's unique. It's a purpose-built lavender harvester. And as it drives up through the row, it lifts and squeezes the plants together. Reciprocating knife cuts it off so that when the harvester has passed over it, you can see it's been formed perfectly in a dome, ready for next year's growth.
But did you know anything about lavender farming before you started?
No, we didn't. We had gone to Provence on holiday and saw how it was grown in Provence and harvested and distilled, and that was something that we thought we could try and do over here.
Business is flourishing, and today 50,000 plants are grown over 10 acres of farmland. There are over 100 different varieties, and many of these can be found in the farm's pretty lavender garden, the passion of Francis's wife, Judith.
Hi, Judith.
Hi.
So this is your beautiful lavender garden.
Yes, it is. And we've got lots of different varieties of lavender here.
But your main area is English lavender, is it?
That's right, yeah. Yeah, we focus on English lavender, which is this one over here, Folgate. The English lavender, of course, has been famous in cottage gardens for centuries, and it's a beautiful, hardy lavender, which is great for our English climate.
And what about this
variety?
These
are the Stoicus, often called the French lavender.
Okay.
And they have these sterile bracts at the top. But the flowers are actually these little dots down here.
Yes.
And these aren't that hardy. So if you have a hard frost and they're in your garden, you can lose them.
Where does lavender come from?
Well, it comes from the Mediterranean originally. It likes really sunny, dry, free-draining soil.
So not very English at all.
No, but lavender has won our hearts and has become part of the English cottage garden
hasn't it? It does feel completely synonymous with that.
Once harvested, around 80% of the lavender grown at the farm is distilled on site to produce oil, which is used in aromatherapy to treat pain, relieve tension, and improve blood circulation. But dried lavender can also be made into crafty and creative products. Judith has some to show me.
You make so many different things with it. Apart from that, you can, you know, make some really pretty things at home yourself with the dried lavender or the fresh lavender flowers. The humble lavender pom-pom.
Yes, just to keep a room smelling lovely. Oh, these would look lovely hung on a door.
latest product, popular in Provence, is the lavender wand, handy for a sock drawer. It's something you can make at home after a little practice. The stems are bent backwards to form a cage around the buds, which is then held neatly together by woven ribbon.
Oh, there's something very satisfying about this.
It is, yes, and you can sit and while away a few hours in the afternoon with your friends and have a chat.
Maybe I'll sit here and have a cup of lavender tea.
Yes, please do. Be very welcome. You can try some lavender shortbread too, if you like.
Only if you insist.
But before I get too comfortable, there's the small matter of finding out what Debbie's next step is.
Afternoon.
Hello.
It's been a busy couple of days. Debbie, what would you like to do now?
What I would like to do is to perhaps follow up one of these houses.
I'm guessing house number two?
You're guessing correctly. You're guessing correctly.
So a second viewing?
Yes, definitely.
Just the two of you?
No, Sandra's...
I'm going home.
Oh.
Yep, and my daughter is coming down mm-hmm. this evening and she will accompany me on the second viewing, so that's she'll have an input.
And if your daughter likes it just as much?
If she likes it just as much, then we'll follow up with some more searches and then maybe approach the owners with a view to making an offer.
Tell us why you like house number two, the Somerset farmhouse, so much.
Love the environment, proximity to a farm, the hamlet aspect, but the house itself was open, spacious, character-filled, a little bit quirky in some ways, but every turn there was a surprise, and it was a pleasant surprise, and it just felt comfortable.
And you felt quite instantly that it was a place you should consider.
Absolutely, it was definitely Debbie's type of place, even from the outside before we went inside, and then outside again, it just confirmed everything, and more so, didn't it?
Yes.
Well, we wish you well.
Thank you.
Good luck with house number two.
Thank you very much.
And I hope that you feel happy enough to make it all happen. You never know, in a couple of weeks.
I look forward to visiting.
Yes. And thank you for bringing Sandra along. She's been a lot of fun. It's been a great couple of days.
Thank you.
A pleasure.
This is a huge move for Debbie, and it's happening because of family, so it's completely understandable that she wants to involve them in her second viewing of house number two. This is the beginning of a new chapter in Debbie's life, and I can see how excited she is about it. We wish her the very best, and I look forward to hearing news of her moving here to Somerset very soon. See you next time on Escape to the Country.
Debbie went back to the longhouse with her daughter, but in the end, she decided it wasn't for her. She's since bought a property in North Petherton, where her family live. If you'd like to escape to the country in Wales, Scotland, Northern Ireland or England and need our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.